something that remains untouched, unmoved. Only that is something that can really look at what is trying to move it. You have CCTV cameras, right? You have CCTV cameras. The camera shows a person coming towards the camera, and the camera is able to show that. The camera shows that person pulling out his gun, even that the camera can show. Next, the camera shows that the person is taking aim at the camera, even that the camera can show. Next, the camera captures the gun shooting a bullet towards the camera, even that the camera can show. And after this, the camera shows nothing. Why? Why? Because the camera itself has moved. The camera is no more there, it is gone. You will be able to see nothing if that which you are seeing moves you. What was the camera looking at? The man with the gun. But the man with the gun succeeded in displacing the camera itself. So the camera is now worthless. That which you are seeing must not be able to move you. Otherwise, your seeing will stop. You do not merely see something. You allow the thing to influence you. You become the influenced one. You forget that the seen thing and the seer of the thing are both not you. You become one with the seer. The seer is bound to get influenced. That cannot be avoided. What can be avoided is that you do not become the seer. This is the thing in the market. Chocolate cake. This is the seer. It is impossible that the seer looks at the seen thing and feels no vibrations. It cannot happen. The very act of perception is bound to change the perceiver. You have to be somewhere else. You are neither of these two. The mistake that you make is that you become this one. And if you become this one, you are bound to get
influenced
by this.
Saying that I become the perceiver of both?
You do not become the perceiver of the both. You are at a place where there is no perception. I understand. Many a times by many a teachers, even in many scriptures, it is mentioned this way. You are the seer of both the subject and the object. This sees this. This influences this. You go and be busy in an apple orchard. In that apple orchard, there are no chocolate cakes. I'm talking about the orchard of the Father. You remain occupied there, even as the senses remain occupied with the
object.
You have to be somewhere else. It's not as if you are looking at these two and are yet influenced by these two. Yesterday we said the real observer observes nothing. You should have nothing to do at all with this business of cakes and the purchaser of the cake. This is the cake, this is the consumer of the cake. You stay where you must. All this cakey business is not your business. The place where you are is not a place of consciousness. All consciousness is in between these two. You are where you always were. You are at your one unshakable position. You are where there is no space. You are where there is no territory to run to. Now, where is the question of running? Even if you want to run away, there is no space to run away. You are at a place where space and time do not exist. All space and time is here, in the dimension of consciousness in between these two. You are...
somewhere.
Actually, the confusion is understandable. When I am saying you are somewhere else, you are imagining that somewhere else is some other place. That this is happening at the bakery,
yes,
and you are at the coffee shop. No, that's not what I am saying. That's not what I am saying. You are where there is nothing.